Hi, welcome to my channel again. If you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe. So in this video, I'm going to show you how we can record a macro and how we can apply this at the time of preparation of the reports. So let's take, okay, this is the total sales for Mark in the month of April. He used to sell headphone, phone and laptop. And also the sales numbers is also given and also the price. So we want the total value of each items he sold. So let's do one thing. We will record a macro for this. So I'm going to, so in the view tab, you can see here macros. And from here, you can give record macro. And here you can give the shortcut key. I'm giving Control Shift Z. Okay, and I will give okay. If you want to give any description, you can give that and click okay. And now it's the recording starts. I will give equal to and the sales number multiply the price. Okay, so this is the total value. And now if you scroll this, you will be getting the details. Okay, now we will stop this macro. Now we will try to apply this in the month of May. Okay. So this is in the month of May. So there is one more thing he is used to sell. Okay. That is television. It was not in the previous month. Now let's try to apply this formula. Okay. Go to macros and here you can see view macros and here run. So you can see that the details of the total value of the television is not there. So there is some error in our formula, so that it's only taking up to this range. Okay, only three items are it's calculating. So let's do one thing. We will change this formula so that we will get all the details. I will do one thing. I will delete all these values. And also I will delete this macro and I will create a new macro so that I will get all the details. Okay, now we'll try to apply the new formula. So, okay, I will record first. I'm giving the shortcut key Control Shift Z. Okay, I will give a macro name. Okay, I'm giving the macro name as this, and I'm giving the shortcut key Control Shift Z. Okay. And after that, okay. Then we will give equal to sales number into price. Okay. Now we will copy this formula and go to the previous cell where we will select the range. So go left and then give control down arrow so that up to which cell the data is there, it will be selected. So give control down. Then make use of use relative reference and then go to right. Then again switch off the use relative reference. Okay. And then give Control Shift up arrow and give Control V to paste. Okay. Now we will stop this macro. Now let's apply this for the next month. Okay. So here we will give the macro which we have created now. And give run. So you can see that you have got all the details of the items he sold for the month of May. Okay. So this is how you can create the macro and apply it while preparing the reports. I think you understood this concept. If you like this video, subscribe my channel for more video updates. That's all. Thank you.